Hello guys, I hope you have been well. It has been a long time before I uploaded something. So I want us to do something on optimization using discrete element or EDM software. Please, you should note that EDM software, it's not an ideal software to draw complicated geometries. As you have seen, it can only create cylindrical box or flat or a polygon. So you don't design your machine in AutoCAD or Autodesk Inventor or any other software that you think is good for you. Then save that design or the CAD design in either IGS or step model or whichever model that you prefer. And then you import it to EDM just as we did in the ball mill example. Now, what is optimization? See, in EDM, it can only help you analyze maybe something like where you're using discrete or energy or power. So what exactly is optimization? People mistake optimization only for minimizing. It can be minimizing or maximizing the response or obtaining the input variables which give you a minimum value of where, or obtaining maximum minimum variables or variables which give you the maximum efficiency. So it can be any. So how will we do this? We'll need the bounds or the limits of the independent variables. So in this case, I don't want us to work on the geometry. I just want us to work on the process parameters, which is maybe the number of particles. We want to investigate the number of particles and also the rotational speed. We want to see how it affects the wear or the normal cumulative contact energy. So this is what we already did. And as you can see, I imported my geometry. So it's the drum. So I drew this in CAD, then I imported it here. As you can see, it has this gear like parts. You cannot draw this in EDM. So some of these features, you have to draw them in AutoCAD. So don't be lazy, try and do something. Now let us go back to now we need the bounds or the limits. So in this case, I'll just use only two: the rotational speed and the number of particles inside the drum. Now the next thing that you need to do, we need a statistics software so that you can obtain the simulation sheet. So I'll use Minitab in my case. Now we do our simulations as guided by the chart obtained in step 2. So we'll obtain a chart here. I'll show you how to do that, and then fill our responses for each simulation. So we'll have now to do simulations depending on the number of simulations that will be given by the statistics software, in this case Minitab, and now obtain the objective function. And then use either genetic algorithm or MATLAB to optimize it, or we can also use Minitab. There is a feature in which you can just put you want the minimum, it to give you the minimum or the maximum values or the target value that you want. Now, for the example to be used, as I said, we are going to use our ball mill simulation for relative wear. So we have our variables. Our variable is rotational speed. So I'm going to vary the speed from 1 to 5 and also the number of particles from 500 to 2500. So as you can see, we have so many speeds. We have like 1, 1.1, 1.2, 1.3. So if we just say we want to vary it manually, we'll have a problem. It will be an infinite number of simulations. So that's why you have to go to Minitab, and because you only have two limits, we'll use full factorial method. Now, and also we are dealing with energy. Full factorial is ideal. You can use Taguchi depending on your research area or depending on your preference. But according to research or what I've read, full factorial has a less mean square error than Taguchi. So I think full factorial is better and it's much user friendly than Taguchi. Now, and also Taguchi is used, it's only used when you want to get the variables which affect the response. But in this case, we already have our, we know what we want to investigate. It's not that if we didn't have the input variables that we want to investigate, now we'll have used Taguchi to obtain the critical variables that affect the response. But in this case, you already have it, so you don't need to go to Taguchi. Now, even for 500, you can use 501, 502, 503, and that will, there will be so many. Eh? You'll do so many runs because also these variables, they interact with each other. Huh? They interact with each other. There is a way that they interact with each other, but we'll see. We'll see later in Minitab. Now, let us go now to obtain the number of runs by calculation, what we expect. Now, for full factorial, we'll have 2 to the power of 2 runs. So this is 4. 2, this 2 represents the number of the limits. Eh? We have the lower limit and the upper limit. So we don't have a middle limit. So it's 2. And then power, this power represents the number of variables. So we have 2 variables. We had 3 and only 2 limits will have one. We'll have put 2 to the power of 3, which is 8. So in this case, we only have 2 runs, 4 runs. Now let us go now to Minitab. So this is my Minitab. So for Minitab, you'll want to do this. Now let us save this project first before. So and just put optimization. Remember, this is just an example to guide you. Optimization example. So we want to go now to statistics, then DOE, this design of experiments, and then now create factorial design like that. So we have 2, we have number of factors is 2. Now we have now to go to the designs. Number of center points per block. We don't have center points. So center points is just like the software will decide. We can put 1, 3 like that. So we can put 1. We only want 1. So number of runs, as you can see, it has already given us. Number of runs is 4. Resolution is full. 2 to the power of 2. Now you say okay. And now, as you can see now, the other parts have become active. So now we click factors. So factor number 1, let us rename this as RPM. RPM. And now you know it's from 1 to 5, like that. And here we'll name this one as particles, and it is from 500 to 2500, like that. And as you can see, one is A, one is B. So we have to remember this. So now come to options, do not fold, just let it remain as that. You can put randomized runs, or you can uncheck this if you want to. So yeah, we can uncheck it. So okay, and then factors, the only difference of randomizing runs is just the arrangement that will be here. You'll see that in our case it will be 1, 2, 3, but if it's randomized, it will be maybe 5, 3, 1, like that. So there's no much difference of that. Now we go to the results. We want summary table and that. So, because this is just for example. Now, as you can see, we have now the order 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we have 5 runs. And now, as you can see, we have 1, 500. We have like that. So these are the changes that we'll be making. So as you can see, it has created these 2. We have 3 and we have 1500. So this is my center point, the one that I put. So you can even have 3, 4, 5, it depends. So because we only put one center point, as we can see, we'll have an extra run. But later we'll come and try and do composite design, which we will increase the number of runs. Now let us go now to our simulation. Yeah, so what you want to do is to save this, save us, but now we don't, that we come here to optimization, create this one. We have this is run one. Run one like that. Relative where run one. Now we click save. Now for run one, for the first run, we know that we are going to put RPM of 1 radian per second. In fact, it's not RPM. Remember, it's radians per second. So I just put RPM for just to name it. It's not RPM. So you're working with radians per second and number of particles 500. So just come here, put kinematic, put one radian per second like that. And then we come to the factory static. Instead of 2000, we want to put only 500 particles. And then we say save. And then now we come here. Instead of going all the way to 10 seconds, we just put 5 seconds. And we start our simulation. So we'll do this for the rest. I'll do them when offline. Then we'll come and analyze the results. Now going back at EDM, our first simulation has completed. So at 5 seconds, so we want to go now to our cumulative contact energy. So we want to work only on the normal contact energy. So let us go. Remember how we did the geometry. So we don't want to color by that. Normal cumulative contact energy. We don't want legend. As you can see, it's very, very minimal. So let us see if anyway, let us export these results. So you go to file, export, and then results data. So you remember what you used to do. You must add that one, configuration ID, and then you have to name your file. So we say this is for run one like that, and then we want relative and normal cumulative contact energy. Now we click query, and then we go to geometry. As you can see, it's already here. So now we want total. We don't want maximum. We want total. We can just put, do we put maximum or? Because we want to minimize it at the end, can put, we put maximum. Let us see what maximum does. And then here, we don't put all sections. So we can put, yeah, it's all sections because the factory is virtual. So it's even also for the container. So then we come here. We have to change this. There is something that time steps. So you want at the end of it all, 5 seconds. So iterations, no, we don't need iterations. Precisions, good. Now we export. So file name, we can put .csv. CSV. So that is good. So we export, and now we go to where it is located, and then we see what we have. So run one, let's see what we have, if it's good. Yeah, it's 0.55. So this is the maximum geometry. So you want to get the minimum. You want to get the minimum. So we'll work with this. This will be our response for the first run. 0.00005. So let us see if we export now the total, for the total. And then we see. We can even add another one. Let us put total. Then we see if there is any difference. So we put total like that. It has already exported. It's that fast. So there's, we have the total, geometry total, numocumulative. So this for all the surfaces, all the areas which have wear, and then it has added all the cumulative energy. So I think, no, let us work with the maximum. The maximum normocumulative contact energy. Let us work with maximum. So now you want to change something else. Now you come to Minitab. Now you put this value of 0.00055041, like that. Now I'll do that for the rest of the simulations by changing these values, the input variables for all the simulations. So the best thing is just come, save us, and you save it as, and then you do all the, you just change as we did. Yeah, now let me go back to that. Yeah, but before I go back to that, there's something else I will want also to do that. So the central composite, but let us work with this, and then we see if the output is good, then we can settle with this, but I'll still have to show the central composite. Now, after 5 simulations, we have now our results. We have exported all the maximum cumulative energy. Now, in our Minitab file, the worksheet, we did not have this column, C7. So this is the response, so I call it wear energy. And now I put the values of maximum, all the maximum values of energy, not normal cumulative energy. So I put them here. Now, the next thing that we need to do, we now come to the start. As you can see, we have various values. As you can see, we have a minimum here and we have maximum number. So we have now to come and get now the relationship between the RPM and the wear energy. Now the best thing to come to do is to go to start, then DOE. Remember we had full factorial. Then you click analyze. So analyze, so this is my response. As you can see, you have to put the response, then you say select, and then you come and take the terms. Remember our input variables were in column C5 and C6. Now we come to the terms here. Now here it's only one, it's only one term. So we want to put them into the power of 2 so that there is that interaction between the two. Now we can include the center points in the model and we say okay. Now graphs, we want to see if we can get graphs. So we have the effects plot, we have the Pareto half normal, then that's okay. Then we want to see the, do we have any options? No. So we want to see what the results will get. Yeah, this is okay. Now we say okay. As you can see, we have a problem here. We have a problem because this is the line that shows the factors which affect the rate of wear. But according to this result, the effect, all of them, they are below this red line. They are, in fact, they are far. They are very far away. Now, to deal with this, now we'll have now to redesign again and see if we can get something good. To this, you see, even we don't have the p-value. We have, let us see our model, where energy. Oh, now we included the center point. Now, maybe you can try and redo it without the center point. Starts DOE factorial. Now we do analyze, then we come to terms. We don't need the center points, we need only 2 terms. AB, then we say okay. Okay. Yes, as you can see, they are still way below. Huh? We have removed now the center point. Now, if you want to get your equations, just come here to the report. Now, this is the report. Now, this is the relationship between wear energy and the output and the input variables. As you can see, we can put one variable as X, the other one as Y. So we want to see, you can see all of these p-values. You can see they are way, they are higher than 0.005. So the best thing to do now is to create a surface response. Let us see if now we can get some 3D plots and see how they look. I want to remember where the 3D plots are. Factorial surface plot, yeah. Want to see how they look. So we have where energy. Want to see how they look. We don't want anything linear. So yeah, this is not bad. It's not bad. As you can see, we want to rotate it. Let's rotate. As you can see, we have the maximum value, we have the minimum value. So the other thing, you can come here and now we see if we can optimize it. So a response optimizer, you come to the response optimizer like that. So we want goal, we want to minimize. We want to see the values which will give us the minimum. So you go to setup. That one is okay. So we want to minimize. We say okay. Then we see what we'll get. So it tells us that these are the, this is the minimum. Now, as you can see, this is kind of biased because let us come to the window and then we do worksheet. You can see it has just picked the minimum value. That's why we need something else. That's why you can't just do full factorial just like that and you leave it at that. So now we need to create a new project, or we can just work with this one. We can work with this one, but the best thing is to create just a new project. Now let's just work with this one and come here to response surface, create. Now in this case, now we want to do a central composite, but the designs that are there, just come here, face centered. You don't want default, because default will give us, remember our, let's open this, remember our limits. If we don't put face centered, we'll get values outside these bounds. But we don't want that. We want all the values to be within the bounds. So let us come here to, now we put face centered like that and we say okay. Now all the factors are in, so we want factor A. So let us call it rad, and then factor B, let's call it par. So it's particles and rad. Now here we want to put 1 to 5, and then here you want to put 500 to 2500 like that. And now for the options, we don't want it to randomize, or we can put randomize whichever way you want. Let it just remain in that order, and then we want the results. Summary table like that. Factors we already put. Cube points, it's in the cube, so, and it's okay with that. Now we want now to press okay and we see the kind of sheet that we'll get. So where is the window? Worksheet 2. Now this is now our new worksheet. This is what we'll work with. So you see, I put rad and par so that we don't confuse. And you can see the number of simulations, they have increased. And we have now 1, 1, 1, and then we have 3, 500, 3, 500, 1500. There are so many. And then now we'll put our response here. And after that, now we'll come back and view the results that we want. Now, remember our equation that we got. We want to do something about that before I go and do the other simulations. Now we go to the equations, we go to the session manager so that we get the equation that we obtained as the, now this equation that we have here, we can let one of them be, let's say particles to be y. Y and RPM to be X, so that our equation will be something like this. So we have our wear energy, so that's our response. Now we put W, let us just call it W, is equal to 0.-0.039 plus 0.046 x plus 0.000018 y minus 0.000018 xy. So that's our equation. Now this is our objective function. So using our genetic algorithm, now we can use this as our objective function, so that we can optimize it. And then, instead of even talking a lot, let us go now to our MATLAB. Now, picking up from where we left, now we want to go to MATLAB and use this equation as our objective function for the genetic algorithm. So we'll remember, I did a video, I think I've mentioned it, I did a video. So we have to assign the variable y and x into x1 and x2 like that. And also remember that we say that x is RPM, so that will be x1. So x1 will be from 1 to 5 as the upper and lower limit, lower limit and upper limit respectively. And y will be a variable 2, which is number of particles from 500 to 2500. So let us go to MATLAB. I have already coded that. So this is my objective function. As you can see, this is my objective function. I've put respectively x1, x2, just as similar to this equation, minus 0.039 plus, and so on and so forth, as shown here. Now, my genetic algorithm is here. My upper limit, now for the values of x1 and x2, there it's the first one because it's x1 like that. X2 is that, if you had x3 in that order, that it will be rows and columns. So the values of x1, all of them, they should be in one column, and so on and so forth. Now I need to run this and get the maximum value. And in the meantime, let me be launching Minitab so that, yes, I have already finished the simulations for the composite, but I'm not interested in that right now. So let us go, that will be in another video, part two of this video. So we go to worksheet one like that. Now in this case, it has come here. Now we run this, change folder. So we run this and then we get the optimal value. So now, as you can see, we have some outputs here. Fval is the minimum value that we can get. So we have the upper bound, lower bound, and this is x. Is that x is equal to this. So this is the value of x at the optimal value, at the optimum value. So we want now to put this as the target function in Minitab, 0.007. So we come here. So we go to start, DOE, factorial, response optimizer. So now we don't want to minimize now. We put as target, and then we put 0.007. Then we say OK. Yes, as you can see, now the maximum, the optimal value the optimal value of the RPM should be 1.7347, and the number of particles should be 2500. However, remember, none of this, according to the Pareto chart of effects, none of this is critical. Remember the red line that I showed previously. It's not critical. So we have found that the current value, optimal value, rad/s, and 2500 particles. So we leave it at that. For those who don't remember, we can just come back to the session. Come back to the session, and now we go to Pareto chart of effects. This is what I mean. None of this is critical because they are below the dotted line.